With rectangle problems, you may have to draw two rectangles to see what's happening clearly. If you multiply or add to the smaller, you can make it equal to the bigger. Rectangle. In example 1, each side of a square is decreased 6 inches. So we have a square, and we'll call the sides x. Since it's a square, the sides are equal. From here, we need to recognize that they're decreasing both sides of the square by 6. So this new little square in here, the sides are defined by x minus 6 and x minus 6. From here, we know that the area of the larger square is 16 times the area of the smaller square. How many inches is the side of the original square? We know that the area for the large square is defined by x squared. We need to make the smaller area equal the larger, so we'll multiply by 16, since we know that the larger square is 16 times the area of the smaller square. The sides will be defined by x minus 6 squared. We can FOIL the x minus 6 squared, and we get x squared is equal to 16 times x squared minus 12x plus 36. We can now distribute the 16, and we get x squared is equal to 16x squared minus 192x plus 576. We can now set the equation equal to 0 by subtracting x squared from both sides. This gives us 0 on the left side of the equation, and 15x squared minus 192x plus 576 on the right side. Now we can divide out the common factor of 3 in each of our terms and recognize that 0 divided by 3 is still 0. We get 0 is equal to 5x squared minus 64x plus 192. From here we can use the quadratic formula to solve for x. A is equal to 5, b is equal to negative 64, and c is equal to 192. X is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared, or negative 64 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 5, and c, which is 192, all over 2a, or 2 times 5. So x is equal to 64 plus or minus the square root of 4096 minus 3840, all over 10. This simplifies further to 64 plus or minus the square root of 256 over 10, and our x value, simplifying even further, 64 plus or minus 16 over 10. If we find the positive 16 value, we get x is equal to 80 over 10, or 8. And the other version, where 16 is negative, gives me 4.8, or 48 over 10. This side, if the original square was 4.8 units of measure, you could not decrease this by 6. So this one does not work. So the sides of my square, original square, are 8 inches. Moving on to example 2. The length of a rectangle is 9 feet longer than it is wide. So here's my rectangle. If this is the width, then this has to be the length. If each side is increased by 9 feet, then the area is multiplied by 3. So here's the larger square, rectangle. We have x plus 9 plus 9 and x plus 9, because it says it's increased by 9 feet. Then the area is multiplied by 3. So this area is 3 times the first area. From here, we can write our equations. If we know the area of the first square is x plus 9 times x, and we know that this one is 3 times that size, we should multiply this whole thing by 3, and that will equal x plus 9 times x plus 18, which is the sides of the bigger rectangle. Now it's simply a matter of solving this whole equation for x by setting it equal to 0. FOILing out, we get x squared plus 18x plus 9x plus 162. This gives us 3x squared plus 27x equals x squared plus 27x plus 162. If we subtract 27x from both sides and subtract 3x squared from both sides, we get 0. Dividing everything by a negative 1 to clear the negative 2x squared, we get 2 times x squared minus 81. From here, the 2 would simply divide out, and we'd get x squared minus 81, which is the difference of squares. This factors to x plus 9, x minus 9. Setting the factors equal to 0, we get x is equal to negative 9 and x is equal to positive 9. Obviously, you can't have a negative distance, and so the side of our rectangle is 9.